So hi, I'm Prasad and I'm an advocate practicing most of my time for High Court of Hyderabad. I stay in Hyderabad and in free time I do videos like this and help people. I love to do my job. So now, today I'm going to help you, right now I'm going to help you with a remedy where you are planning to purchase a property, a real estate property. But the seller informed you that the property is in court proceedings, is entangled in court proceedings. I would like to put it that way. Now, can you purchase that property? And the answer is yes. But there are some conditions. The first point is whether there is any order not to alienate the property, not to lease out the property, not to sell the property, etc., etc. Is there, the first question you need to ask when you're buying a piece of property, immovable property from a seller who already says, informs you that there is a court litigation pending on that property, or you come to know about it that there is a court litigation pending on that property. In such an event, can you buy that property? Yes, you can buy that property. But the first thing you need to ask is whether there is any court order prohibiting you to purchase, prohibiting to alienate. Then there will be stay orders. So if there is a stay order, then you are not supposed to purchase it. Then it will be contempt of that court. If it is a high court, it's a high court contempt, or if it's a lower court, it's a lower court's contempt. So therefore, the point you need to understand is you can buy the property subject to not having any prohibition from the courts. So now if you buy the property and if there is no prohibition from the courts, what will be the effect if at all the seller loses the case? Then your sale, your purchase is subject to the result of the court. And it is better to inform everything in the sale deed and pay all the entire amount by way of account pay check. And also, you may incorporate the condition which prevents you from claiming or disputing the compensation part or the interest part. It is better to incorporate in such kind of cases, it is better to incorporate the arbitration clause, it is better to incorporate the compensation clause, it is better to incorporate the court case proceedings number, etc. All those details, if they are incorporated and your purchase is purely subject to the result of the court. So you have to take all those precautions before purchasing that property. So the point you need to understand is you can purchase a property if it is in the court proceedings, but beware and check for riders, check for any stay orders, check for any sort of prohibition from the court, check from the sub-registrar's office. Sometimes court passes a direction to the sub-registrar not to register. Even contact the sub-registrar also. Sometimes in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, it will be entered into a register called prohibitory register, which is maintained by the sub-registrar. So it all depends on the court's orders or the government orders. So check that before purchasing the property, and I think then you'll be safe. So in property purchase, the principle that is to be employed always is investigate before invest. Please remember this phrase, investigate before invest. If you do that properly without any compulsions or prejudice, then I think you can always buy, or you will always buy a good property. Okay, so you can always purchase a property which is in the court proceedings, because right to live is a fundamental right. So if it is a house property, you have the opportunity never comes back again. So the point is you will be subject to the outcome of the result of the court. So that is what you need to keep it in your mind. Okay, thank you, thanks for watching, bye bye.